Welcome to the Thursday, June 25th, 2015 edition of Erner Berry's Market Video, sponsored by Eastern Poultry and Food Distributors. In today's video, a federal judge blocks Sysco's bid for U.S. Foods. Then later, chicken stocks in cold storage are highlighted. But first, with predictions for the latest quarterly Hogs and Pigs report, here's your host, Jamie Chadwick.
The USDA is set to release its quarterly Hogs and Pigs report on Friday afternoon. An Erner Berry survey of analysts indicates larger supplies are expected throughout the year. All hogs and pigs as of June 1st are projected to be up 8.1% on the year. The breeding herd is expected to be up 2.1%, which would be the biggest since 2008. The kept for marketing number would be the fourth largest ever, up 8.9%. If the average guess of the analyst proves correct, the data would show producers have clearly overcome or offset the losses from PEDV. Be sure to check back on Friday afternoon for the official report and analysis to be posted on Comtel. Next up, Sysco's $3.5 billion bid for U.S. Foods is blocked by a federal judge. Here's account manager Adam Sharkey with the story.
A federal judge on Tuesday issued a preliminary injunction blocking Sysco Corp's planned $3.5 billion acquisition of U.S. Foods, a ruling that could kill a deal to combine the nation's two largest food distributors. The Federal Trade Commission filed a lawsuit in February challenging the transaction on antitrust grounds. The case now shifts to the FTC's in-house administrative court, where the agency will seek to permanently block the deal. The Sysco U.S. Foods deal, announced in December of 2013, sought to combine the food distributors that lead the pack in providing ingredients and a range of other supplies to restaurants, hotels, schools, and other food service operations. The FTC argued the merger would leave customers large and small vulnerable to higher prices and reduced levels of service. The companies argued that their tie-up would help improve service and become more efficient while cutting hundreds of millions of dollars in costs. For more information on this and other news from the center of the plate, please visit foodmarket.com.
Thanks, Adam. Finishing up today's video, we have poultry market reporter Terrence Wells with an analysis of chicken stocks in cold storage.
In the USDA's latest cold storage report, which covers holdings through the end of May, total chicken stocks were up over 126 million pounds, or 20.6%, compared to their year-ago levels. All major categories except for wings continue to reflect an increase in holdings. Breast and breast meat stocks are still higher by 28 million pounds, or 24%. Leg quarter holdings, which are up 47 million pounds, or 40%, remain well above their year-ago levels and for reasons that we continue to cover. As if a strong U.S. dollar and devalued oil market isn't challenging enough for processors to overcome, the presence of avian influenza has resulted in numerous bans and restrictions on several states, further impacting the dark meat complex. As previously mentioned, wings are the only item that continue to show a decline in holdings. Through May, they were a mere 44 million pounds in cold storage compared to 66 million pounds just 1 year ago. Also important to note, wings are the only chicken item featured in Erner Berry's poultry price comparison that are valued higher this year than last year.
Thanks, Terrence. That concludes today's show. Thanks for watching and have a great day.
This broadcast is sponsored by Eastern Poultry and Food Distributors, wholesalers of poultry, beef, pork, and seafood since 1954. Visit them online at epoultry.com.